celebrate Mario's public execution on the 31st, I'm going to be comparing my two favorite Mario games, Mario Odyssey and Mario Galaxy. These are some of my two favorite Mario games, and I'm going to be putting them head-to-head to see which one's better.
Now, keep in mind that I love both of these games, and they both have their strengths and weaknesses, and I'm just going to be picking them apart and see which game has the most strengths and less weaknesses. There's going to be 5 rounds: bosses, controls, level design, soundtrack, and replayability, and we're going to see which one wins the most. Now, I'm just going to get this out of the way. I'm not nostalgia blind by any of these games. I played both these games pretty recently. I played Odyssey for the first time 2 years ago, and I played Galaxy for the first time during quarantine. So I'm not nostalgia blind for any of these games. It's just going to be purely based on their merits. Before we get this video started, make sure to like, subscribe to my channel so I can get a bunch of subs off of this video. I'm hoping that it does well because my Hollow Knight versus Cuphead versus video did very, very well. So I'm hoping this one does just the same. So make sure to like, subscribe, and maybe share it if you like it that much. Without further ado, let's start the video. This video's main premise is inspired by YouTuber Odyssey Central. He absolutely hates Galaxy, and I think all of his opinions are ludicrous, so I'm trying to tear them apart, but I do respect his opinions on Odyssey, and he's a great YouTuber. Let's start with Mario Galaxy. Mario Galaxy is the cream of the crop of level design in the Mario franchise. It just started a whole bunch of trends, Mario Galaxy 1 and 2, that the whole Mario series would follow after. Even Mario Odyssey has hints of Galaxy in it, in level design. But it's just constant platforming. It strayed away from the exploration of Sunshine and 64 and went for a more linear format. And I am all for that. Exploration of Mario games is okay. I usually like exploration like Zelda or something like that, but Mario, I just want a platform, so Mario Galaxy is more my style. From start to finish, the platforming in this game is amazing. It just never stops. I love this game so much with his platforming that it has. Some of my favorite levels in the Mario franchise are in this game, like Melty Molten Galaxy, Gusty Garden Galaxy, Freeze Flame Galaxy, and all, just a bunch of them. Good Egg's really good. Honey Hive is really good. I can just keep naming them. Matter Splatter Galaxy, the Bowser levels are good. The last Bowser level is amazing. The platforming is amazing, and I can't say enough about it. Now let's get to the meh side of Galaxy. I've just been gloating about the good stuff. Now the meh stuff comes from the motion control stuff they try to push down your throat. Now the good thing is, these are far and few in between, but whenever I see one, I usually just like, ugh, I have to do one of these. Like the rolling ball levels or the manta ray levels. The manta ray levels are pretty fun, but they're just really annoying. And the ball levels, I hate them. I'll straight up tell you, I hate them. Awful, awful levels. But it doesn't take away, because there's only like one ball level in the game, and there's like a section of Melty Molten Galaxy, which is one of my favorite galaxies in this game, so it doesn't take away from that. But still, I don't like the motion control levels. That's just a minor nitpick, because they're far and few in between. So yeah, Mario Galaxy has amazing level design, and it influenced games like Mario 3D World too. Now, Mario Odyssey is complicated. It is a mixture between platforming level design and the exploration of Mario 64 and Mario Sunshine. I don't really know what to classify it as. It's a weird mixture of both. So most of the time you're just going to be randomly exploring and randomly finding moons laying around, like, hey, I just stomped the ground at this point. Oh, I got a moon for that. When in Mario Galaxy, you have to do a certain mission to get a moon, which there are mission moons in Mario Odyssey. I'm not saying there's not. Okay, so I'm going to give you an in real life analogy of these two games. So Mario Galaxy, okay, it's like you have a job, and you have to work for your money. And once you get the money, it feels more satisfying. So in Mario Odyssey, let's say you have a job and you walk around randomly and kick a stone, and your boss hands you a check of $100. Would you feel satisfied? I mean, yes, you'll be glad you got the paycheck, but would you be satisfied? Unlike Mario Galaxy,
you just worked 9 to 5 and got a $100 paycheck at the end of the week after working for 40 hours a week.
I don't know how else to put it, but there you go. There's a Clutchathan analogy for you. Even though the moons aren't as rewarding, they still are fun to find. No, don't get me wrong. I still love it. And with Mario Odyssey, as you're going to see in the control section, it's really fun to move around. So you're having fun either way. It's just you might have more fun in Galaxy doing all the platforming challenges. And here we go on the other thing. Mario Odyssey does have platforming challenges, but they're hidden in this room. And there's like 2 or 3 rooms in a kingdom. And let's say there's about 60 moons in a kingdom. So that means you have 3 platforming challenges per kingdom, which is not good. Even though the layouts are somewhat platforming, but they're just not all the way platforming. Let's take the Sand Kingdom, for example. One of my favorite kingdoms. You just roll around like Sonic the Hedgehog for most of the time, trying to get from one place to the other. You just have empty sand. When in Mario Galaxy, you're always platforming, and you're never just mindlessly rolling around and looking for your next objective. I'm not dissing Mario Odyssey at all. It has good level design, but it just doesn't have Mario Galaxy type level design, if you know what I'm saying.
So overall, Mario Galaxy takes this round by having really, really good platforming and a lot of missions and not any mindless exploration and mindlessly finding moons and stuff like that. Still really good for Mario Odyssey, but Mario Galaxy does it better.
Remember how I was talking about how Galaxy has the best level design? Well, it came at a minor cost. They took away a lot of Mario's moves from Mario 64 and Sunshine, like the dive, and a bunch of other fun moves you could use to toy around with. But there's a reason why, so you can stay on your objective and not fool around. And it's still very, very fun to move around in Mario Galaxy, and Mario's a little bit slower too. This game started the linear 3D Marios, like Mario 3D World and Mario Galaxy 2, and all those. So I'm not mad at it for having a nerfed moveset for Mario. It's not bad. You still got the long jump, and then you got the new spin move, which is really helpful. It's still got really good controls, but what you're gonna see about Odyssey is they took back all the moves from Mario 64 and Sunshine, and added some new ones. So you're gonna see what I have to say about Mario Odyssey. But Mario Galaxy has good controls, but it's very, very nerfed because of the environment it's in. Overall, a decent moveset for Mario, but it is forgiven, obviously, because of the top tier level design. Mario Odyssey has the best controls in the Mario series by a long shot. This game is so fun to move around in because of the controls. They're all just crisp, and it's not that hard to learn how to do dives and cappy bounces, and once you get into all the hard stuff, it still comes natural because you just gradually get better at the game. Mario's moveset is as big as it's ever been. It's even bigger than Mario 64 and Mario Sunshine, about what I think. Maybe Sunshine has a little bit more, but as I know, I think it has the most. With all the cappy bounces you can do, the dive, you can do long jump, triple jump, side jump, all the stuff you can do in 64, but you can just do stuff with cappy too, which is really cool. And also you have the capture mechanic is awesome in this game too. I never get tired of thinking of a new way to do a different objective in this game. Like in Bowser's Kingdom that I'm in right now, I'm doing it a completely different way as I did it my first time going through. The first time I paid attention to everything, but now I'm just doing cappy bounces and flipping, flopping everywhere like this is the Matrix and I'm Neo. I'm just flipping everywhere. It's because I've gotten a lot better at the game. When in Mario Galaxy, you stay the same skill level the whole time. Granted, the levels get harder in Mario Galaxy as you progress, but your skill basically stays the same. It's just you're better at doing platforming challenges. Like, you're not going to be doing any crazy flips or anything because its moveset doesn't require any flips because you don't have any, basically. Like, I had a blast playing through the footage for this level just because I have a blast moving around. Just getting footage for this video was a blast because it's just so fun to move around in Mario Odyssey once you learn how to do everything. You just get creative. And that's a big reason why I got into speedrunning this game. Granted, I'm not very good at speedrunning this game, but I did pretty decent. My time's like a 150, something like that. But still, it's just so fun to move around in Mario Odyssey, and I don't think it will ever be topped by any other Mario game, just because this is peak Mario movement right here. Unless they make a Mario Odyssey sequel, that is. Mario Odyssey wins this one by a country mile.
Oh my god!
Now it's time to discuss the bosses. For Galaxy, the bosses are incredibly diverse, and there's so many creative ideas for the bosses. One of my favorite is Bouldergeist, and that's the one I'm going to be playing on screen. So his gimmick is, in the first part of the level, you learn how to use the black boos, which you get to swing around like a lasso, and they have bombs at the end of it. So you learn that at the beginning of the level. So whenever you fight Bouldergeist, you have to whack him with those black boos until you locate his heart, which is that right there. And you whack it, and then he's done. But then he gets harder, and his second phase is super, super hard. And I like him just because he's one of the harder bosses, and it has a really cool mechanic. Like, he's my favorite, but the other bosses in this game are really good. Like Dino Piranha, Major Burrows, a bunch of other bosses are really good too. Bugaboom, he's decent. He's the one from Honey Hive. He's decent, but all the other bosses are really good and really unique for a Mario game, not just jumping on his head. And the Bowser boss fights are amazing in Galaxy. It has the best Bowser boss fights in the series, in my opinion. With the music, the atmosphere, and they're just really fun trying to hit Bowser while he's rolling around. It's just really fun. The bosses in Galaxy are top tier. Now, Odyssey has some banger bosses too, especially Mecha Brutal. That boss is amazing. And Bowser boss fights are awesome in this game too. Not as good as the Galaxy boss fights, but they're still really fun. So like Bouldergeist, I'm going to analyze my favorite boss, which is the Mecha Brutal. The Mecha Brutal is a boss centered around the Pokio, which is a capture you get in Bowser's Kingdom. So you have to hit these bombs at the legs to knock it down, to climb up the legs, then destroy the individual rabbit inside, or Brutal if you want to be more technical. And it's really fun trying to figure out how to get up there. And there's a speedrunning trick, which is really cool, where you can hit a Brutal and then keep like Cappy bouncing over and over again and then hit another one. And it's pretty cool. I've done it before and it was really hype. Overall, this is my favorite boss in this game. And it might be better than Bouldergeist. But the bad thing about Odyssey's bosses is that they're not as consistent as Galaxy's. Like, there's a handful of bosses that I really don't like in Mario Odyssey. The four Brutals, when you fight them, are bland. Like, just jump on their heads and they got a minor tweak. And the Mecha Wiggler, oh my gosh, is it one of the most annoying bosses in Mario history, especially when you're speedrunning. That boss just triggers me. But the alien ship flower thing in the Forest Kingdom is really cool too. It has some really good bosses, but it's just not as consistent as Galaxy because it has some bad bosses too. But like I said, I love the bosses in this game, but I think Galaxy slightly edges Odyssey out in the boss department. This boss is fire too. Okay, bye. kind of sum up the replay value for Mario Galaxy really quick. So if you don't have all 120 stars, you can replay to try to get all 120 stars. And if you got all 120 stars, your reward is
Super Luigi Galaxy!
Mario Odyssey, on the other hand, has a new kingdom added, new moons added to all the kingdoms that you can find and explore. Granted, they're not as interesting as the first ones, but still, they're fun to find, and more content added to this game, yes please. And it's fun just to move around in this game, so you're just going to be practicing all the time on your moves with Mario. It's just so fun, and then you get into speedrunning, and then you just keep replaying it over and over again, and then you just love the game because you replay it all the time. It's just what I have been. So this game has the best replay value of any Mario game ever by far. So this just sweeps the floor with Galaxy with replay value. Sorry, Galaxy. Now for the soundtracks of the games. They both have amazing soundtracks, but I'm going to go into depth on which one is better. So I've played quite a few songs from these soundtracks in this video, and I think you can tell which is which if you know anything about these games. Mario Galaxy would be the classical orchestra score, while Odyssey would be the more diverse jazzy slash orchestra music. Now, Mario Galaxy soundtrack is one of my favorite soundtracks in gaming, so I'm definitely going to be more biased towards it just because I love it so much. It is what a comment put it best. It is the Beethoven of video game soundtracks. It literally sounds like something ripped off the 1600s, 1700s type of orchestra, and I love it, but it has its own Mario twist to it. So I'm going to let you listen to a little bit of classical music and then a little bit of Star Wars music, which I think it resembles, and it's a mixture of both. Compare it to Galaxy's amazing soundtrack. And it's not just this epic orchestra music that makes Galaxy's OST so memorable. It still has some melancholic music, and also it has some upbeat music like Beach Ball Galaxy. That's like a Mario Sunshine type of song. And it's pretty diverse, but it likes to stick with the orchestra, and I'm not complaining at all. Now, Mario Odyssey's soundtrack is more diverse than Mario Galaxy's. It has like one orchestra song, which is playing in the background right now. It has like a bunch of jazzy songs. It has some weird Japanese songs. It has the lyrical songs, which I'm not a fan of in a Mario game. And it just has a bunch of other songs. So it's very diverse, and I love it for that. So I'm about to blow your minds with controversy. Jump Up Superstar is overrated as heck.
Why you pulling me? I'm right!
But Mario Odyssey's even got some rock and roll in it too, which is really cool. So overall, Odyssey has a great soundtrack and is really diverse. Way more diverse than Galaxy's soundtrack. But Galaxy's orchestra is just so amazing. And it is one of my favorite soundtracks of all time. So Odyssey's can't be better. Now, if I haven't convinced you enough that Galaxy's soundtrack is better, it has the greatest song Nintendo's ever written, the staff roll for Mario Galaxy, and it has been voted Nintendo's number one song it's ever composed, and I definitely agree with that. As much as I hate to do it, one has to lose this contest, and it's Mario Odyssey because Galaxy did win the contest 3-2. So if you watch this whole video, thank you, because this is my longest video I've ever made. And I put my heart and soul to it. because this is a 20-minute long video that took me 4 days to edit and voice record. So please hit the like button. And always know that Mario the Galaxy is the best Mario game ever. Besides Mario Galaxy 2, that one's better. Bye. Now thanks to all my patrons who helped make this video. Clutchathan, 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 and Clutchathan. Because I have no patrons. Bye.